Hey everyone, welcome to Architecture for Thought. In this video, we'll take a quick look at ControlNet, which is a neural network process designed to provide additional user control to AI-generated images. The process uses a variety of techniques to lock the image composition, allowing you to apply your prompt directly to the subject or the geometry within your image. A couple of techniques it uses to achieve this are Canny Edges, which track either prominent or distinct edges in your images, or Depth Maps, which qualify spatial attributes to your images. Let's jump right into some examples that exist right now. We'll start with Scribble Diffusion's website, and I'll leave a link in the description of this video. When you click on it, it'll bring you here, and you'll select this button that says Try ControlNet, and here you have the option to upload an image. I'm going to select an image of a project we recently completed, which is a fitness center. This is an image of the lobby or reception area, and I'm going to click run on this and read you guys off the prompt. It's an architectural interior rendering of a modern fitness center, lobby, matte black walls, concrete floor, modern reception desk, pendant lighting, artificial lighting, natural daylight, spa interior. And it usually takes 15, 20, 30 seconds, but I selected this image because of the unique geometry in it. And I'm gonna open this, which is the Canny Edge map, and show you how it's mapping out the distinct edges in the image. So here you can see it's drawing out the reception desk, this frame, the window opening behind the reception desk, even the lights and some of the duct work in the ceiling, the curved walls. And here is the image that it produced based off of that prompt and based off of the image. Not bad. The image quality isn't quite at the level of Midjourney or some of the other synthetic image generators, but it's a really good start. And this is the same process that is being used behind the scenes in programs like Evolve Labs Verus for Revit, and what I suspect also is being used for Adobe's new Firefly text to image generator. So pretty interesting. You even have some options here. You can produce more than one image at a time. The image resolution is default set to 512. There's a high and low threshold for the canny edges. And then what's also interesting that I'm starting to see on some more generators is basically a guidance scale or a slide, which tells you either to focus more on the image or more on the prompt while the image generator is producing an image. Next, we are going to jump into, I guess, what's called ControlNet Scribble, which uses a very similar process. And I've already got an example here of another project my company is working on. It's a facade remodel for a medical center. And in this, you can see it's sort of a black and white map that it's trying to draw. But it does a pretty good job of at least identifying the windows and the signage, maybe some vehicles and people. And the prompt I had for this was a modern medical facility, all black facade with accent lighting, earthy tones, entry canopy in an urban setting during a bright, colorful sunrise. And it did an okay job, not bad. Again, the image quality is not necessarily up to par with Midjourney version 5. I don't think anything else is at this time, so it's hard to compare to. But also with this generator, you have the scale, you have different seeds that you can feed into it. So there are some tools and additional parameters that you can play with. Because it had the seed in this generator, I was interested to see if I can upload a different rendering of that same project to see if I plug the seed in and it would create a similar architecture or design. And it didn't really. I had to sort of search for a seed that looked sort of similar to it. So there's definitely some drawbacks still with these tools. And I'll talk a little bit more about that towards the end of this episode here. But I did want to do an example of this at least. Again, I'll leave links in the description of the video for you guys for all these web pages. And when you come here to the ControlNet Scribble, this is the example that it has prepared for you on the screen. I'm going to click and upload a modern home project that my company's working on, and I will click enter. And as this process is, I'll read off the prompt. It's a modern residential home design, all white facade, vertical facade panels, large glass windows, wood accents, entry canopy on a bright sunny day in a grass field. So this is the first time I'm attempting this, and pretty interesting results. It's definitely modern. It's definitely white. I chose the white because I wanted to just see basically if it would swap out the color on my image, and it did. But it changed the roof, changed a little bit more of the geometry as well. But it still has a canopy in there. It is a bright sunny day. The perspective is pretty similar. So it's interesting. It's not quite there at the level of one-to-one, you know, swapping out just the prompt or just the materials within the prompt on your image, but we're getting there. I think you can see how we could start to get there with tools like this. So the last tool that we are going to review is kind of a silly one, but it's pretty fun actually. I've had some people asking me some questions about floor plans, and there's some sophisticated tools out there. I know plugins that use generative AI to lay out floor plans and furniture within floor plans. This is nothing like that. It's much more raster based, meaning it's working off images. But I did want to show you the example that I came up with here, and this is just a floor plan that I drew, and the prompt over it was architectural floor plan, residential home, foyer, two-car garage. I think there was some more. Yeah, living room, great room, kitchen, back patio pavers, etc., etc. And here's the result it came up with. Again, it's kind of a silly tool with a little crayon that you basically draw in, but I think you can start to see how, you know, you can do something like this, bring this into Revit, trace over it, extrude the walls, just like we do now with rasterized PDFs, if it's not a digital version. I know I've done that hundreds of times. I'm sure you guys have too. There's some other examples here. I started drawing maybe like a 3D image, and you know, it started to produce that. And the prompt on that was architectural floor plan, residential home, bedrooms, kind of simple, but I thought we would do kind of an example together. Just acquired a new client today that's building out a medical facility, and the floor plan was pretty abstract. So I was kind of gonna draw something that looked like the floor plan that I surveyed today. And it was something like this, not the best layout for a commercial space, but basically the doors were here, and I'll just draw those in. And you know, they wanted to lay it out so that there's a reception desk out at the entry here, and there was a waiting area with chairs off to the side, and then maybe wall off a partition here. Do some smaller medical patient offices here. And then you need things like a break room, storage, and maybe just some open space back here. So this is just totally an example. I'm doing this kind of live off the cuff here. But let's go down and prompt together. We'll say an architectural floor plan. We'll do a medical office layout, reception area, waiting room, patient offices, storage room, and click go. And the results on this are really quick. And you'll see, again, this is a silly tool, but with the sketching abilities, you know, you can see how it may be a tool that we may be able to incorporate in Revit or some other documentation type processes. So this one didn't turn out very good, but you can always run it again. And maybe we have to take out some things, or I'm just going to take out medical office. I don't know if it knows what that is. And we'll try it again. But that's basically it. That's what I wanted to show you today. I've been talking a little bit more about ControlNet and how this is sort of a behind the scenes process that has been integrated in some of the tools that we're starting to see. I think, you know, I did want to say that I've started to receive a little bit of criticism for the AI tools, or at least showing them, or the images that are being created, and that's fair. I think, you know, there's criticism on what the tools are capable of doing now and what they're not capable of doing right now, and I think there's a lot of hype around the technology. So it's easy to see how, you know, I think things can get overhyped, and then to see the actual state that they're in, that it's less impressive. But we have to remember that the tools that we're seeing right now are in their very early stages, and there's companies like Evolve Lab that are taking these tools to the next step for us in our documentation and design programs. And I'm here to basically show you the same thing. I want to show you guys these tools so that you can start to experiment with them on your own. I think there are a lot of new tools being developed really quickly, so it's hard to invest or overly invest in any of the tools individually, but it's definitely something to take note of. And if you're curious or excited about it, I think it's okay to get involved in these stages. I will be using artificial intelligence to the best of my ability with this new client for this medical office, and I'm thinking about producing a little series for anyone who's interested in following along to basically see how we'll be using some of these tools, like this silly Scribble 2D floor planner, to then bring into Revit, extract the walls, come up with a basic 3D view that we may be able to put into one of these other ControlNet image generators and prompt over a design for. I'm all for human creativity and natural intelligence, and so I want to make sure that I'm balancing the artificial intelligence tools with the creative process of human intelligence and natural intelligence. So if you're interested in any of that or all of that, I encourage you to stop by. I thank you for tuning in for this video, and I hope to see you for more videos. Thanks a lot. Bye.